Good morning, everybody. Good morning. First of all, please verify two important things that you all can hear me properly and the screen is clearly visible to each one of you in the class. If both the things are okay, come on, give me thumbs up on the chat box and let's begin with this lecture number 6 of Animal Kingdom, Phylum Mollusca and Echinodermata. Come on, everybody. Can you all hear me properly and is the screen visible? Right now also there is echo. Right now there is echo. It might be actually the chirping of a bird. It might not be the echo. There's a small birds around me, that's why. Is my audio clear? Is my audio clear? Can you hear me properly? Just verify that and let's move on to the session. Guys, please be fast. Don't waste the time. Yes, thank you so much. So today we would be having a discussion of everything along with after 2 or 3 days, we have come back with yet another live lecture. So I told you, you have to take down all your doubts. And if you have any doubt, you have to clarify with me today itself here itself. So this is your lecture number 6 on Animal Kingdom. Hope you guys have read the NCERT and is preparing along with me till now. Have you all prepared till Echinodermata or have you all prepared till yesterday's class? All topics, have you read the NCERT? Have you prepared and have you learned the topics up to Arthropoda? Just tell me. Very important chapter. You will get nearly 4 to 5 questions for NEET exam. Okay. So those who are not even studied, so please do watch the lectures and complete the topic as soon as possible. Okay. So those who are brand new to the channel, don't forget to join our Telegram group t.me/NEET_biopoint. Where daily session updates, regular discussion, polls, doubt clearance, and everything takes place. Those who are watching the session right now, don't forget to hit the like button, do share it with your friends, and subscribe the amazing platform for NEET Biology. Yes, the DPP paper for today's class of Animal Kingdom is uploaded in the description box. Complete it and send to my personal Telegram ID mentioned in the group. And the question paper link is in the description box. Guys, please see to that whether you all can see a link in the description box regarding the DPP paper and just give me hearts on the screen if it's clear. At the end of the class, we would be doing 10 questions based on today's class. And then along with that, we would be discussing last day's discussion paper also. Okay, because if any one of you have any doubt, you can clarify with me right here itself. Is in the description box, is it visible? Nobody is commenting anything. A very silent class. Guys, please tell me whether you can hear me properly. Yes. So today we are going to discuss about phylum Mollusca. Okay. Today we are discussing about the phylum Mollusca. So we have discussed about phylum Porifera, which is actually the pore-bearing organism. Second, we discussed about the Coelenterata, that is Cnidaria or Coelenterata. Third, we discussed about the Ctenophora, then Platyhelminthes, flatworms, Ashhelminthes, roundworms, Annelida, we discussed segmented worms. Arthropoda, it is the largest phylum in the entire animal kingdom. And now we are studying about phylum Mollusca. So first of all, you have to be very clear that Mollusca is the second largest phylum. Okay, it is the second largest phylum in the entire animal kingdom. Okay, it is the second largest phylum in the entire animal kingdom next to Arthropoda. And phylum Mollusca, they are soft-bodied shelled animals. They are soft-bodied shelled animals. They have a very soft body, but they have shells covering their body surface. So they are called soft-bodied shelled animals. They show organ system level of organization. They show organ system level of organization. Okay, everyone. Is it clear? Only Binaya is responding to me on the chat box. Where are the others? Abhijit, Lucifer, Ash, where are you guys? Yes. Anyway, so you have to, this point is very important. It can be asked for the exam. And we already studied that segmentation or metamerism is present in three different phylum. Can any one of you tell me on the chat box in which all phylum have we observed the segmentation? In which all phylum we observe the segmentation? Or segmentation is also known as metamerism. This is also a very important question from this part. We studied that metamerism is first observed in Annelida because they are the segmented worm. Okay, yes, absolutely. Annelida, Arthropoda and Mollusca. Sorry, Annelida, Arthropoda and Chordata. Okay, so you have to remember the point. The mollusks are not segmented, okay? Segmentation is not seen in Mollusca, okay? Next, they show bilateral symmetry. They show bilateral symmetry. What do you mean by bilateral symmetry? They can be divided into two equal halves through any plane. Look, they can be divided into two equal halves. They can be divided into two equal halves is the bilateral symmetry, okay, through only one particular plane. They are also triploblastic organism. They are also triploblastic organism. They are also triploblastic organism. That is, they have three germinal layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and entoderm is there. This diagram is very important, very, very important. This would definitely be asked for your exam. Okay, for you to draw in board exams. Okay, for you to draw in board exams, they will ask you to draw the diagram as such for the board exam. Draw the neat and label diagram of a triploblastic animal. Then you have to draw this diagram. It contains the outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm, and the inner entoderm. Okay, ectoderm, mesoderm, and entoderm. They are coelomate. They are coelomate, that is true coelom is present. That is a body cavity and mesodermal lining is there between the body cavity and the gut wall. Okay, so they are true coelomate. Look, this is the structure, this is the coelom. Coelom is present inside the body of a mollusk. Then, they are aquatic organism. They are mainly aquatic organism, few are terrestrial. They are aquatic organism, few are terrestrial organisms also. Aquatic means they are living inside the water. Terrestrial means they are land organism. Okay, they have a complete digestive system. That is, look, everybody look, they have a small opening here. They have a small opening here, which is known as the mouth. And they have another opening at the back side of their body, which is known as the anus. Okay, that is why their digestive system is said to be complete digestive system. that is having both mouth as well as anus in two different parts or the two different structures. Is it clear? Give me thumbs up on the chat box, everybody. Everybody give me thumbs up on the chat box. Participant number is showing 4. Only one is responding. Is it clear what is digestive? Yes, Lucifer. Very good. Yes. So it have a complete digestive system with two openings, that is a mouth and an anus. Next, the respiratory organ is gills in aquatic forms. Okay, aquatic organism respire with the help of gills, whereas pulmonary sac is seen in terrestrial forms. Okay, aquatic organism respire through gills and terrestrial form respire through pulmonary sac. Okay, so they respire through gills and pila. Okay, P-I-L-A, which is a mollusk example. Pila globosa, which is a terrestrial organism that respire through pulmonary sac. Very important. Okay, for your NEET exam and all, they'll ask pila belongs to which phylum. So pila, P-I-L-A, it is a soft bodied shelled animal. It belongs to mollusca. It respiratory structure, it is a pulmonary sac since it is a terrestrial form of an organism. Next is circulatory system. They consist of open circulatory system, that is blood is directly pumped by heart into the body cavity. Okay guys, this is the heart. Okay, this yellow color which I am drawing over here, it is the heart. There is no particular blood vessel to carry their secretion. Look, the heart pumps the blood directly into the body organ. All the internal organs are bathed in blood. Okay, all the internal organs are bathed in blood. You have to remember this. Next is reproduction. Mollusca are generally dioecious. What do you mean by dioecious? The sexes are separate. That means sex organ, that is male organism is there, female organism is there. So sex organs are present in two different individuals or two different organisms. Is it clear? Mollusk, they are oviparous, egg-laying animals. Development is direct or indirect. Is it clear for everybody what is dioecious, oviparous, and direct and indirect development? Guys, please be active on the chat box. Please try to communicate with me by asking your doubts, by asking your questions, everything. So please be careful. Okay. Next we are going to study about the unique features. Okay. Unique features of phylum Mollusca. The body is divided into head, visceral, hump, and muscular foot. Okay. Their body is actually divided into three different parts. Head is there, a visceral hump is there, and a muscular foot is there. This is an important point. Guys, in Malayalam, we'll call this mollusk. That is this particular organism. We'll call them as kakka and all we'll call. Okay. This is used for eating also. This can be... Okay. Used for eating. The head has sensory tentacles. The head portion has sensory tentacles and they have a calcareous shell. Okay, this point is one of an important unique feature. Okay, their body is divided into head, visceral hump, and the muscular foot. Next is they have feather-like gills. Okay, they have a feather-like gills. Look, they have a feather-like gills. For respiration, the excretion. Very important statement. Mantle and radula are seen. Two different structures, two different unique structures. Two different unique structures are present. That is mantle, which is the pallium, the membrane which covers the visceral mass. The space between the hump and the mantle is called the mantle cavity. Okay, so guys, this hump-like region, okay, this hump-like shell region is known as the mantle. So below this shell-like region, you will see a particular structure which is called the mantle. This entire hump-like region, you'll call them as the visceral mass. Okay, then this is a repeated previous year question. Radula is a file-like rasping organ. What do you mean by rasping organ? Rasping organ present in the mouth of mollusk, which is used for feeding, that is used for the capture of prey, which is for the capture of prey. So in this mollusk, you have to study their body is divided into head, visceral hump and the foot. They also have the presence of a particular rasping organ. That particular word is very important. R-A-S-P-I-N-G, rasping organ. What do you mean by rasping organ? They help in the feeding process. They help in holding the particular material. Okay. So this is the structure. So guys, this is the head. This is the visceral mass. This is the muscular foot. Number one. First point. Second one, second point, they have the mouth at this opening. Yes. Once again. So much breaking. Guys, can you all hear me now? Can you all hear me now? Yes. Perfecto. Yes. So this is what we were discussing about the mantle. So the mantle, actually, this is a shell. Okay, this is actually a shell which is comes under this visceral mass. Okay, so the visceral mass, there is a space which is present between the hump and the mantle, which is called the mantle cavity. Okay, mantle is actually one of a layer of this shell. Okay, mantle is actually one of the shell, one of the layer of this shell. Look, different layers are present. So mantle is actually the layer of a shell. So between the mantle and the hump, there is a cavity which is known as the mantle cavity. Is it clear? So they have a mouth over here and they have anus over the tail region. That is the, they have a complete digestive system. They have a complete digestive system. Okay, everyone. Then, this is a very, very important slide. You can take a screenshot of this. Very, very important one. Okay. The examples generally and very important. They are asked for the exam for the match the following type of question. That is, first one is pila or apple snail. Pila or apple snail. You have to see both the thing. Pila or apple snail. Painted up, pearl oyster, painted up, pearl oyster. Painted up or pearl oyster. Third one, it is sepia or cuttlefish. This is very important. Cuttlefish, don't write it as fishes. It is belonging to phylum Mollusca. It is not a pisces or it is not a fish. Okay. Here also the same thing appears, same doubt appears. Devilfish, they'll ask you a question. Devilfish belongs to which phylum? It is not belonging to Chordata. It is belonging to the phylum Mollusca only. So you have to study what is the common name of devilfish. That is octopus. Octopus is a devilfish. Cuttlefish is the sepia. Loligo, which is a squid. Loligo, which is the squid. Okay. Loligo, which is actually the squid. Then aplysia, which is a sea hare. Very, very important previous year NEET MCQ. Of the four belongs to phylum Mollusca. Sea hare. Okay, sea hare belongs to phylum Mollusca. That is aplysia. Oh my God, the voices. Guys, what about now? Is it clear? The voice is clear. Now I think it's okay. Yes. So aplysia, which is the sea hare. Next. Dentalium, which is a tusk shell. Very important previous year AIPMT question. Okay, previous year AIPMT question. Dentalium, which is a tusk shell, and Chitoplura, which is the chitin. Okay, so I'll tell you which all are the previous year question. Previous year question is pearl oyster, pinctada, sepia, cuttlefish, octopus, devilfish, aplysia, sea hare, dentalium, tusk shell. These are previous year NEET, AIIMS, AIPMT questions. Clear, everybody? So this example is very important. You have to have a look on dentalium, aplysia, sepia, octopus, and pinctada. It is a bit difficult to by heart, but anyway, you have to write it and study. Now let's look at the characters at a glance. That is, they are organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, triploblastic organism, coelomates. Aquatic is there, terrestrial is there. Complete digestive system. For aquatic organism, they respire through gills. And for terrestrial organism, they respire through pulmonary sac. Okay, gills in aquatic forms and pulmonary sac in terrestrial forms. They got an open type of circulatory system. They are dioecious, oviparous, direct or indirect development. The body has guys hope it's clear. Hope this won't happen again. Anyway, let's move on to the session. So these are the characteristics at a glance of phylum Mollusca. Is it clear? Just give me a hearts on the screen. Come on. Just give me hearts on the screen. And let's move on to the next phylum. That is phylum Echinodermata, which is actually the last phylum of invertebrate organism. Yes. Phylum Echinodermata, that is a spiny skinned animals. Phylum Echinodermata, they are the spiny skinned animals. Okay, so first of all, we have to study that they have organ system level of organization. Okay, they have an organ system level of organization. The adult show radial symmetry. The adult echinoderms show radial symmetry, whereas the larvae shows bilateral symmetry. Okay, the adult echinoderms show radial symmetry and larvae shows bilateral symmetry. Very, very important point. Okay, so this is a very important point. Echinodermata is only phylum that show two different symmetry at two different life stages. Yes, larval form. Abhijit, where were you? Late for the class. Okay, do watch the first phylum. Okay, so larval form, you'll tell like larval form. So larval form, that means the earlier form. For example, the larvae will only be converting. The larvae will only be converting into the adult in case of indirect development. They are also triploblastic organism. I'm not going to explain again about the triploblastic. They have three layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, entoderm, because we have already discussed detailedly in the first class regarding what do each layers function for. They are also true coelomate. They are also coelomate. They are exclusively marine. Very important. Very, very important point. Guys, just look at the variety, the vast variety of organism that God have created. Look, this is a starfish. Sea cucumber, Cucuminaria. Look how beautiful each organism God have created. They have a complete digestive system. They have a complete digestive system. That is, they have the mouth. They have the mouth and they have the anus. Two different opening. They have a ventral mouth and dorsal anus. Ventral mouth and dorsal anus. They have dermal branchiae. Okay. They have a dermal branchiae, that is skin gills or papillae, and tube feet. Tube feet is actually a structure which helps in locomotion, as well as in respiration. Respiration and locomotion too. Okay, this is the respiratory organ in phylum Echinodermata. You have to study that. Okay, dermal branchiae or gills, skin or papillae, open type of circulatory system. Okay, they have an open type of circulatory system. They are dioecious. External fertilization, indirect development, ciliated free swimming larval form. Their larval form is ciliated and free swimming. Is the slides clear, everybody? Because all these things we have studied earlier, that's why I'm moving a bit fast without too much of explanation. If you need explanation, please do ask me. Okay, they have an endoskeleton which is made up of calcareous ossicles. Head is absent. Water vascular system is present. Guys, when we studied about phylum Porifera, there we studied about one water system. Name that water system, guys, on the chat box. We studied a same technical term relating like this in phylum Porifera. What was the term? Unique feature of phylum Porifera. What was that canal? Is it? Water canal system, there we studied. Okay, water canal system. The same water transport system is known as water canal. This is phylum four. And what are guys, can you all hear me now? Can you all hear me now? Can you all hear me now? Yes. Sorry for the inconvenience which is made in between. Okay, sorry for the inconvenience. It is due to some technical glitches. Okay, I hope you might have heard about this calcareous. Have explained what is calcareous shells. Calcareous shells or calcareous ossicles means their endoskeleton is made up of calcium carbonate. Okay, their body is made up of calcium carbonate. So you have to be very careful about this particular statement. That is the water vascular system is seen in phylum Echinodermata and water canal system is seen in phylum Porifera. Okay, water canal system in Porifera. Water vascular in Echinodermata. Okay, these things you have to be careful. Water vascular or ambulacral system. Ambulacral system, okay. Seawater enters through porous plate called matriporite. They have small pores. Okay, they have small pores on their surface. They have small pores on their surface, which is known as the matriporite. And the seawater enters and reaches the radiating canals and tube feet. Tube feet helps in locomotion, respiration, capture and transport of food. And excretion, the foremost function is locomotion. Okay, you have to be very careful about this thing. These are the example: Asterias, which is a starfish, Echinus, which is a sea urchin, Echinocardium, Antidon, which is a sea lily, Ophira, which is a brittle stars, Quicuminaria, which is the sea cucumber. Give me hearts on the screen and let's move on with the glance of this phylum and finally to the paper discussion. Some questions we can discuss right now over here. Just please tell me. I hope everybody can hear me properly. Yes, thank you, Binaya. What about others? Lucifer, Abhijit, everybody. Yes. So let's move with this organ system level of organization: radial, bilateral in larva, triploblastic organism, coelomate, exclusively marine, complete digestive system, ventral, mouth and dorsal anus, terminal branchiae and tube feet as a respiratory organ, reduced and open type of circulatory system, dioecious, external fertilization, indirect development, ciliated free swimming larva, body covered with spines, head absent, calcareous endoskeleton, water vascular system, asterius, echinus, echinocardium, antidon, curcuminaria, ophira. So in tomorrow's class, we will be dealing with this phylum Hemichordata. Okay, next class, we'll be dealing with this phylum Hemichordata. Okay, everybody. So, give me thumbs up on the chat box and let's move on to certain questions from this chapter. Let's move on to some questions of this chapter so that based on today's class. Yes, everybody is ready. So that's all in today's class. Let's move on to question number one based on today's class. Which one of the following is a mollusk? Which one of the following is a mollusk? Which one of the following is a mollusk? Seahorse, sea mouse, sea hare, sea cow. Seahorse, sea mouse, sea hare, sea cow. Absolutely, there is no doubt for anything. It is the sea hare. Okay. Question number two on your screens. Water vascular system is found in. Important question. Water vascular system is found in. Cycan, leech, fish, starfish. Leech, fish and starfish, cycan. Absolutely, it is seen in starfish. Water vascular system is seen in starfish. And in case of cycan, you will observe what? Water canal system, right? Water canal system. Water canal system you'll observe in phylum Porifera or the cycans. Next, question number three on your screen. The animal with the tube feet, important question. Animal with the tube feet is known as. Tell me the answer fast, guys. Animal with two feet. Starfish, jellyfish, silverfish, crayfish. Starfish, jellyfish, silverfish and crayfish. Yes, absolutely. The correct answer is starfish. Tube feet is actually the locomotory organ. Locomotory organ in Echinodermata, starfish. Next question. Which mollusca is known as tusk shell? I told you to remember this. This is a very important question. This is a previous year AIIMS 2004 question. Absolutely, there is no doubt for that. It is Dentalium. AIIMS 2004, very easy question. Direct NCERT question, tusk shell, it is Dentalium. It's not Pila. Pila is apple snail. Pila is apple snail. Right, it's Dentalium. Okay, Abhijit. Pila is apple snail. Okay, so please, you were not there at the instant, that's why. Next question. Which of the following characteristic is not a function, sorry, which of the following is not a characteristic feature of phylum Mollusca? Which of the following characteristic is not of phylum Mollusca? Soft body covered usually by a shell, segmented body, triploblastic, presence of xylem. Yes, absolutely. I have discussed phylum Mollusca, they do not have segmentation, so they are unsegmented. They are unsegmented ones. Next question. Very, very important previous year need question, rasping organ.